Hello, my name is Richard, also known as Ricky5050 on automaticwasher.org. I joined automaticwasher.org in 2001 when I first bought my house and I got a Bendix LT washer dryer that needed some help. The Bendix had been sat in a pantry down in Leeds, which is about a 2-hour drive away, and had never been used. I'm doing this little video just to introduce myself and also introduce my mum's house, which is just along the road. This is a typical house of the era, all built in sandstone, because I would like to show you her wash house, which is where I keep most of the machines. This is the village of Medamsley. It is recorded in the Borden Book of 1183, so it dates back a long while. It's supposed to refer to the middlemost clearing or the sunny side of the meadow. I've lived here since 1991 and this is my mum's house in the middle. I'm showing you this just because I'd like to show you inside and show you the washroom. Like most houses in the area, it's built of sandstone and a lot of houses are built in a terrace format. Inside, it is typical of most terrace houses that it's a back-to-back construction and has open yards back-to-back with what we would now call a washhouse. This is the backyard to my mum's house. is slightly different. It would have all been originally red brick, and the back of the house would have been stone. This was the outside toilet, coal shed, and this is the washroom. So this is inside the washroom. I've changed it a little bit. It used to be a little bit bigger when we first moved in. This is where the chimney would have been down to the copper boiler. And this wall here used to go into the kitchen, so I've made it a bit bigger, but it's now still a washroom. We've got my mum's meal air set. That's a meal classic, a washer and dryer. We've got my Hoover Ecologic, which is from about 1988. We have the Hotpoint 9605, which is their last version. So I've got the first and the last. And we have the Bendix LT, which is from about 1965. You might have seen Darren's got one of these. And then this is a Hoover Keymatic, but I can't get the bearings back in, so I'm not going to talk about that. It's not playing games. This is a Colston Jetstream dishwasher that I've just put here to do some work with. It's their sort of first dishwasher. Two small racks and a spray arm. It works, but it has a leak. And then we've got the Hoovermatic twin tub, which is Hoover's first twin tub. I need to do some work on that and put some new seals on, so I'll probably do that a little bit later. Right, I've put in the clothes. I've used some colour liquid, and I've also put in a downy ball with some fabric softener. This has programs, so I'm going to use number 4 on heavy soil and see how that gets on. So this is a Hotpoint 9605. It's actually on loan from my king. It's finished in brown and white. Program 4 was a 50 degree program, but if you don't press the heavy soil button, it drops it down to 40. So I've kept that on. So the machine will just keep stopping and starting and heating as it needs to. It'll then do 2 rinses and a slow spin. So I'll decide later on whether to put it on a fast spin because it's quite sunny out there today. So it's just doing its final slow spin. As you can see, it's got a little bit of a wobble, but it's still calmed down. Fortunately, I haven't bypassed the safety switch, so I can't open the spin lid while it's spinning. Has long or short spins, so it'll do the same spin speed of 1050 RPM, but this one will be a lot shorter than the normal 4 minutes that the copper cycle would do. There we have it, all on the line in the lovely Victory in Europe bank holiday sunshine.
glue this in as well. And we'll have lift off.
Thank you. Thank you. This is BBC Radio 4 to mark the 75th anniversary at the end of the Second World War in Europe. We remember in silence all those who gave their lives.